Hi students, so this is the third video for percentage change. So previously we have learned that for this section, we only need to know this one formula. To find out what is percentage change, you can use the increase or decrease in the value over the original value times 100%. So we have gone through all the five levels. Now we'll be looking at the level six, the final level. We'll be looking at level six. So for level six, right, you'll be that there are more than one original values given in a question. That means there are a few values representing different things. So all of them are 100%. And you need to identify that the percent from different values, right, cannot add or minus together. For example, 5% increase in the electricity bill, I cannot find the total percentage increase by taking 3% of the water bill and add up together for 5 + 3 = 8. So it's not possible. Because both of them are two different things. Their original value are different as well. So let me show you one example. So let's look at question three. Okay, so for question three, right? For this question here, let's read the question step by step. So a number 3600 is first increased by 50%. So this means that this is 100%. And this new value obtained here is 150%. So to find what is this 150%, I take 150 over 100 times 3600. And this gives me 5,400. So this is the new value. But take note that now we are looking at the next statement. This now becomes a new 100%. So whenever there's a new percentage change, right, to a certain value, we must always base it on the new value obtained, and this will be the new 100%. So we cannot say that this one is 150% as a base, cannot. We must say that this is the new 100%. So our new 100% will then be 5,400. And to find out what is the final number, I need to first identify what is the final percentage. So 100% minus 5%, it will be 25%. So my new 25% will be 25 over 100 times 5400. So my final value will be 5400 divided by 1350. This will be my final answer. So the thing to take note is that now we have a new 100% when we are looking at the new percentage change. So we cannot use back the 150 again. So we must trade it as a new 100%. As this 75% here is based on this new value as a new 100%. So if you're confused with this part, please text me to ask. Moving on. For question 10, I just want to highlight some parts over here. And I need you to try this question yourself. So this is the cost of the material. This is the labor cost. And this is the warehouse cost. So to make a kitchen cabinet, I require three costs, 1, 2, and 3. So now each of these individual costs, right, it increased by 10% for the material and label. So material is increased by 10%. Labor cost increased by 8%. Well, the warehouse cost decreased by 18%. So you need to calculate the percentage change in the cost of creating this kitchen cabinet. And you need to determine whether is it an increase or decrease. So first thing, you need to know that there are now a few original value, and you cannot just take 10% plus 18%, then minus 18%. So in the end, oh, there's no change. Cannot. Why? Because all of these numbers here, right, they have different starting value. All their original value are different. So the 10% of 250 is different from 18% from 120. All of them are different. So you need to consider each case individually. So how? So first you need to find out 10%. So you need to label first. So for the material cost is 10% over 100 times 250. So I'm trying to find out what is 10% of this $250 for this material cost, which give me $25. So this one is an increase, so I put an arrow up. And for the labor cost, it increased by 8%. So I need to find what is 8% of $120. So it's $9.60. And this one is an increase, so I put an arrow up. And for the warehouse cost, it drops by 18%. So I find what is 18% of $60. So it is $10.80. So this one is a drop. So to find out whether there's any increase or decrease, first thing you need to add up this value first. So the overall change will be $25 plus $9.60 minus $10.80. Why? Because there's a decrease in value. That's why I add minus. So when you calculate, there's an increase in $23.80. So this is increase. So to find out the percentage change in the cost of creating this kitchen cabinet, I go back to the formula again, percentage change. So first thing, I need to find out what is the total value first. So for my total value, is $250 plus $120 plus $60. So this one will be $430. So this one will be my original value. So to find what is percentage change, I'll take the increase in value, which is $23.80, over the original value, which is $430, times 100%. So when I calculate, there's a percentage increase of 5.53%. So you can leave it to three significant figure. So my percentage increase will be 5.53%. This is my final answer. So if you have a question regarding question 10, please ask. So once you have figured out question 10, this shall give you some idea how to challenge yourself for question 11. So question 11, right, basically it helps you to rectify any like misconception that you have, which is a common mistake that most students make. So if you can identify this common mistake in question 11, that means you are good to go for such question on percentage change. Thank you.